Hello everyone watching at home. Welcome again to another fantastic episode. Welcome to another fantastic interview session. And my name is Abisola Alawode, and I'm sure most of us can see the big man we have in the house, the great comedian we have in the house. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Mr. Kenny Blaq.
Yes, oh, we are here.
Yes, yes. Most of you know Kenny Blaq. I don't need to do plenty intro for you for who this man is. Anyone who knows Nigerian entertainment, anyone who knows comedy, anyone who knows music in the industry would know who Kenny Blaq is. But for the benefit of those who are just seeing him for the first time, Kenny Blaq is one of Nigeria's top comedians. Not just a comedian, but he's a music comedian. I'm right.
Yes, sir, yes,
music.
Right.
He's a music comedian who has, in a short time, let me just say in a short time, who has risen to the top, not by any on the ground, any on the gym moves, but by the sheer force of his talent. Anyone who has seen Kenny Blaq perform always has something positive to say. So guys, please do not forget to invite your friends, your neighbors, your uncles, your aunties, everyone watching. All the people that have mentioned Kenny Blaq to you, those that have seen the joke on Facebook, on Instagram, that says this guy, man, is the funniest thing ever. Go and knock on their door now. Go and call them. Start calling them on the phone. That he's live on Nigel.com Facebook. And tell them to prepare their questions. It's going to be an interesting session. Like I always say, guys, make sure you join Kenny Blaq.
Yes, sir. Morga.
Nice. Welcome, man. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Okay, yes, so let's talk. Let's talk. Your name is Kende Otoloyin.
Yeah.
I used to know somebody named Otoloyin. His name is Imam. I don't know if... I think his dad was the local government chairman. We together.
Imam Otoloyin?
Yes.
No, I don't know him. I don't.
At all?
At all.
Okay, it's fine. That's fine. So, Kenny, how did you start the game?
Ah, man.
Tell us your story. How did it happen?
I can't explain how I got here.
Okay.
I can't explain how I became Kenny Blaq. Mm-hmm. But I think if there is one word I will use, I think it would be grace.
Okay.
Because 2008, when I started, it was like a child's play. I just wanted to do it for fun,
okay,
just to make people happy because I love making people happy. But I've always wanted to be a musician with a live band, you know, sing, go to shows, play shows. I used to sing with some Yoruba juju band,
okay,
called name it. I used to work with a lot of them, Shilo, Ajogba Jesu, all of them, a lot of them back then. Mm-hmm. Dari Melody, Alakpanla, I was in all those backup. For them, and
okay,
that made me create the stage presence for me. So I would always do the solo performance before they come up on stage.
Okay.
So. And in our spare time, I crack them up. I play around, turn a lot of songs around.
Okay.
So 2008, I'm talking about 2002, 2003 or something. So that was when I did models, juju music. Mm-hmm. In 2008, somebody walked up to me and he was like, "All this thing what they do for house, come on, you can try it on stage. You can do something." I said, "I don't know." So August 9, 2008. I went on stage for the first time.
Okay. As a comedian.
As a comedian.
Okay.
So, but then I was this clown. I was one guy painting his face, putting clothes in his stomach, wearing vegetable shoes. I was the Baba Salah. In fact, you could call me Adimeru. At that point, I was putting a lot of things in my body. And
okay,
I wanted to make people laugh before I say anything.
Okay.
So that was how I started. And the first joke I wrote, I tried to write a joke and I realized the fact that I was writing a musical joke.
Oh, okay.
I said, okay, let me try it. And I tried it, and a lot of people liked it. And that was how musical comedy started for me, because I got more ovation than the normal stand-ups I was doing.
Okay.
So I said to myself, I think this is my selling point. So I found my selling point then, and I stick to it, and today we are here.
Oh, okay. So you didn't have anyone who was doing that you wanted to look up to?
I still have right now. Likes of people like Baba Salah.
Okay.
Baba Salah did music comedy back in the days. Then, Big Adeboye.
Okay.
Adeboye, I used to watch Fumoton,
okay,
you know, then Fumoton.
Okay.
Then I started seeing people doing music comedy real life.
Okay.
Right now, not the icons who passed away.
Who passed away.
So I started seeing people like Julius Agu. Julius Agu had a band.
Okay.
So remember I said I wanted to have a band sing.
Yeah, yeah.
But I saw a comedian who has a band, who's got a band, who perform with his band and sing and do comedy. So I like that. I wanted to be that kind of person. And CD John also came and was also doing music comedy. So I already started doing music comedy before I met CD John.
Okay.
So I realized that this person is doing something really related to my type of comedy. So I linked up and we started working together, and I went to Calabar Festival. I saw Julius Ago Pamon live with his band and linked up, and that was how I met these people. So they've been doing music comedy before I started music comedy. All I can say is, I guess I just rearranged mine. I gave my own another definition entirely.
Okay.
So I think...
So the Kenny Blaq brand of comedy is different from everything that's out there.
Yes, I think it's different. But I think it's just like, I think it's music. Okay. Just like when you say music, we have different genre of music. So I think my own genre is different.
Okay, let's talk about this musical comedy stuff. I for one, I'm very, it's not like I can say anything, but I've seen you perform at shows and get standing ovation every single time. You understand? It has never failed. To the shows I've been to, it has never failed. You understand? So how do you pick your jokes?
Say you're going to do it like, you're not just going to say a joke like a comedian, but you're going to add the music element into it. How do you pick your jokes?
Man, it's always crazy. And at the same time, amazing. Because getting a musical joke, I think, is one of the toughest jokes to get.
Okay.
Because first of all, you need to have a story.
Mm-hmm.
After having a story, you need to now look for songs that will go along with the stories. Now, you have the raw talent. How do you make it funny? You start looking for punchlines. You look for punchlines, and you add the punchline to the music and the comedy, which makes it funny. Now, how do you present it to people? Now, in that presentation of people, you have to have room for spontaneity.
Mm-hmm.
So they can know that you are also creative.
Okay.
So it's always crazy, and I think God has been able to give me the strength to do that. Being the fact that I love music, I've always been doing music. So it was easy for me to get the song, because I listen to a lot of music, from juju music, R&B, Fuji, hip-hop, country, soul, reggae. I listen to a lot of music. I get bored listening to just one genre of music for too long.
Okay.
So I listen to a lot of the Ebenezer Obey, Kainwenu. I listen to Alaoma Like, I listen to Adele. I'm starting to listen to Westlife now. The next one is Barbara.
So
I can listen to Barbara and I listen to Osadebe. So I was listening to a lot of music, and each time I go on stage, I try as much as possible to use those music to relate to the present condition, present things we're going through right now. Maybe a song is out right now, and I think I'm not supposed to use the genre of music going on right now. If it's trap music going on right now, I need to do something related to trap.
Okay.
So, somebody narrating you a story with your favorite song makes you go, wow. So your favorite song that you're listening to, you're listening to it in another dimension. Somebody's creating a story out of your favorite song.
Okay.
So your favorite song is becoming your favorite song.
Okay.
So that's how I deliver my material. I pick my jokes from music, activities, my friends around me, everywhere. And when I go on stage and I crack those jokes and people give me standing ovation, I go like, wow. At the same time, after that wow, I need to go back to my senses that, okay, I have this standing ovation. How do I keep maintaining this standing ovation? I need to go back to work and do something better than what I did the last time. So maybe this time around, I may not get a standing ovation. I'll get a jumping ovation. They'll turn on top of their chairs. I'll be jumping up and down. Then I need to work. Once I get there, I need to work on another ovation that when I clap, the joke will get a fly.
Everybody on the fly.
Okay. Guys, we're having a lot of fun. Please do join.
I don't know if you know this song. This song by Small Doctor. Penalty. That song everywhere now, man. This small we made a very, very funny video. I saw it on Instagram.
Wow. I don't know.
See, first of all, that song.
That's a street song.
Yes, it's a street song. You understand? And the funny thing is, the way that song is becoming so popular, that it's another topic for another day.
Yeah.
But you were able to do it in R&B.
How
did that happen?
I imagine things a lot.
Okay.
I wake up in the morning and I look at Lil Kesh and I just say, imagine seeing Lil Kesh in a country singer. So I imagine a lot of things. I can just wake up in the morning and imagine, imagine say Adewale Ayiban and King Wasi when he did their rock stars. How would they feel? I just picture that. And sometimes when I say it, my friends usually think like, oh, yeah, just the taker right now. Yeah, bring brother and paper. So I have a producer in my studio, Shaba.
Okay.
And also a guy called Bash.
Okay.
So once he comes, I just call them, okay, just play keyboard, just play anything. So the manager will play R&B, just play any genre for me.
Uh-huh.
And when I heard Small Doctor, oh my better, yeah, man, I was like, ah, my this song is good, but I think we can break it down.
Uh-huh.
Imagine if Craig David did a version, or if Small Doctor was born in Los Angeles
and he was singing the same
tonality. So it should now be I need to create a story.
Okay.
I need to tell a story with the song. Mm-hmm. Not just do a cover, but tell a story. So I was like, imagine Craig David was Small Doctor here. You hear, I met a girl on a Saturday morning in Ibadan. She looks so fine. Yeah. Mm-hmm. She looks so fine. Say, I said, excuse me. They call me Craig David. Can I get to know you? And she said to me, I'm all better. Get my soul back. Yeah. Get my soul. And again, I'm like, yeah, So it's funky now. It's not like that street, like it's also like that. People will shoot attack and listen. Come on, man, this is funky. When you hear the original song, you find that it's not funky. So that's exactly what we do.
Wonderful guys, I beg. You have seen my teeth a lot of times. If you are not watching this interview, I don't know what you're doing, man. Invite your friends, your neighbors, ask them to come and enjoy Kenny Blaq. He's going to brighten up your day, I can promise you that. At least I heard another one.
If I continue with conversation, I have to say this one. It was a song about Ejiro. I think it was Two Faces song we were using for that song. I still have the
memory. Hey, Ejiro, that's your I'm forgetting about this because I just do them and just drop them.
Okay.
But what happened between me and Ejiro was?
Was that the last one?
No.
It wasn't. Okay.
I'm a big fan of Two Faces.
Okay.
I love Two Faces. So I was looking for a way to get to Two Faces. Two Faces likes me because of my jokes. And he likes, but I was looking for a way to get to Two Faces. I needed to dedicate something to Two Faces.
Mm-hmm.
Two Faces was the first person to wish me happy birthday 2 years ago. He did a video, happy birthday to you, Kenny Blaq. And I was like, today, next week is Two Faces' birthday. What can I do for Two Faces?
Okay.
So I went to search for Two Faces' album. From the first album to the recent album, I listened to the album. It took me 3 days.
Okay.
And I decided to do a mashup of songs of Two Faces from day one till now and use them to tell a story between, just like play the scenario of I met Annie. Mm-hmm. But I didn't want to use Annie. I used Ejiro.
Mm-hmm.
So if you listen to Love Criminal, it's out there. You can download it. You can even get it on nice.com. So if you understand the fact that it now looked real, like okay, not true. It got to a point. Ojo, Two Faces, no girls to stay. They went to meet Ojo, and Ojo was like, see, Oya, come, make me go. What should they do for that? And end of the day, Two Faces landed in the prison. And somebody asked, what happened? And it was like, maybe small team. So I tried to create. I'm a storyteller. I like to tell stories. So what happened between me and Ejiro was what I painted, what I zoomed happened between Two Faces and Annie, but using Ejiro.
Okay, wonderful, man, wonderful, guys. Please, I'm sure you can see the lovely drinks we have. This interview is called 1107 Suits and Lounge. It's in Ikeja. See how relaxed you are. You want to be the same, you want to be fly as much as we're doing. Yeah, you can see that, man. Please make sure you visit
1107. It's even microwaved.
Very, very.
Talent.
Yes, 1107 Suits and Lounge in Ikeja. Along Allen. Anybody, just ask anyone, when you get to Ikeja, they'll direct you to where it is. So, Kenny, tell us about, I know for you, in your skits and everything, storytelling is quite important.
Yeah.
Okay, so tell us a story about your background, your family background.
Let's move on to your twin.
Yes.
Let's move on to your twin.
I'm from a family of seven.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
I have a twin sister. I were the last set of twins. Mom gave birth to two set of twins.
Oh.
Yeah, my father must have loved something.
Yeah. Ibeji.
So I have one elder brother, I have another sister.
Okay.
Then we have twins, then twins.
Then twins, yeah. Okay.
So, and I think I have it. My twin sister is, I'm trying to hide her from before. I was trying to hide her before because of all these boys out there. But now, I think I'm not getting any younger. So if you are there and you want to marry my twin sister, just bring the list because the girl where I want to marry for future, they already sent me the list.
Oh, okay.
So I'm not going to give you the list. So when you bring the list, I can only bring the bride price. I'll just carry it and take it to them. So it's, I call my sister bride to pay.
So that is very good people.
This thing we have to do. Yeah. But the most she was amazing. I have a twin sister. She's amazing. She's she's seen at the serious part. All of us know feel the craze for the family.
Okay.
So she's the serious part. She's the serious one. Very intelligent. Like, I'm not intelligent, but she's the more, you know. One of us well, for that house, we'll be born.
So that means that she's not doing that. I think that's a child now.
Because we know the true jokes. Everybody.
My dad is a comedian.
Oh, wow.
My papa the true punchline. Everybody in my family is funny.
Oh, wow.
Even right now, Sam, I don't know what I've done to them in our house.
Okay.
Anytime I look at my dad, I'm like, my dad goes, Kenny Blaq, as they say. Kenny Blaq, as they say. Kenny Blaq, as they say. Because my dad used to tell me, Kenny Blaq, you need to leave this house now. I'm going to go to your own house. So all these people that used to come to the house, different TV, different radio. You better pack your bags. And live in town. I say daddy. I say, my daddy uses music to talk to me. When I tell dad, I'm going out. I'm not coming back this night. My daddy will reply with music. I kill her for Monday. Come on, leave the house. I say, yeah. So, right now, man, in my house, everybody is a comedian. Okay. We all crack jokes. And funny enough, they use music.
Oh, okay.
My daddy is a fan of music. You have been listening to Boyz II Men.
Mm-hmm.
I'm listening to Boyz II Men.
Wait. Your dad listens to Boyz II Men.
Okay, yeah. You might be listening to Boyz II Men.
Uh-huh.
And my dad will just take it out. Okay. And the next thing you see is... My dad can threaten you with music. So my dad threatens you with music. So music is back-to-back in our family. It runs in the family.
Okay, music runs in the family. Wow, yeah. Wonderful. Guys, please make sure you join in this interview. Kenny, let me ask you a simple question.
Mm-hmm.
You understand, you've talked about how music runs in your family, how everybody's doing, everybody's funny in the house.
Yeah.
You understand? But how do you guys then settle conflicts?
In the family?
Yes. How do you do that?
I think we do. I think we've grown to understand ourselves better in the family. Once there's a misunderstanding,
mm-hmm.
we call ourselves, we settle with us. And I've noticed that each time there's a misunderstanding, I'm always the one to sit down. Because they will sit me down and my job is to make sure that after this conversation, after this misunderstanding, after arranging the misunderstanding, we have to laugh.
Okay. So you're the one that will just douse the tension.
When there's a misunderstanding, I have to think of what happened yesterday I can use to crack joke for these people. So I'm always... We're always at home and making everything happen, making everybody laugh. Uh-huh. My brother is also a funny person. So each time there's a misunderstanding, we just end up laughing.
Oh,
laughing
okay. Right. So
and we use that misunderstanding to laugh.
To laugh again.
Like we go sit better and laugh. So imagine maybe in the family now, maybe Taiwo takes daddy's slippers.
Uh-huh.
And daddy was really angry. And they don't want to pass your mom. The following day, if I want to talk to Taiwo, hey. Tell me something, Daddy. Daddy slippers. That's how we forget about everything. So it's always fun.
Okay. One more question. You perform in churches.
Yeah, I do.
Quite a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah, I say more than the average comedian.
Yes. Yeah, so.
You understand? Some people want to put you as a gospel comedian.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of pastors, not just one, not twice, they've come out to talk about the fact that the altar is a sacred place. You shouldn't be bringing comedians to shows. What do you think about that? As a Christian, and as a comedian, what do you think about that?
I think right now, we have some churches where, I think the churches are not just a church.
Okay.
We have event centers turned to church now.
Oh. Okay.
We have event centers whereby you do a wedding on a Saturday,
mm-hmm.
and that place are calling an altar is where the DJ will be.
Mm.
And the following day, there is church service,
uh-huh.
and anointing still flows. That is an example that place is a stage. But once you, as a pastor, you're on that stage, you are the altar.
Okay.
So you have the grace to command things to happen.
Uh-huh.
So you are the altar. So a lot of back then, pastors supported us. One of the reasons why I can say I got into limelight is because I got a lot of support from pastors.
Uh-huh.
They will call me to churches and make me perform. In fact, there was a church that would make me perform almost every Friday. That was how I started. That was how people got to know me in my area. That was how people got to know me. In fact, I think one of the videos that went viral that made everybody know me is KICC.
Mm-hmm.
The one that performed at KICC, I think like three years ago. It was a church. They supported us. So, but I think, so I don't understand why they would say comedians are not needed in church. If the Bible says he that said in heaven shall laugh,
mm-hmm.
so they should not misquote the scripture. I don't know. I don't know based on their understanding, but God speaks to us in different ways.
Okay.
It might be a warning,
okay.
and it might be misunderstanding too.
Okay.
So the pastors need to understand that, okay, we, I don't know just the pastor, I think the comedians also need to understand the kind of jokes to say in church. I won't blame the pastors, because maybe the pastors are saying this thing based on a comedian who came to their church and said something, and said God said when God did not say.
Oh, okay.
And said the Bible said when the Bible did not say. And maybe was cracking jokes about pastors.
Okay.
So, I think it boils down to comedians too. Please know the right jokes to say in church. Do not say things that, like, you know that, ah, when you say it in church, even you, your conscience will be judging you. So I think there's a misunderstanding. I think there are a lot of comedians, people claiming to be comedians and going to church feeling that they can say anything that they want.
Okay.
Maybe somebody went to church and said the F word. Maybe somebody went to church and said shit. Maybe somebody said, went to church and said something. Maybe somebody said, went to church and said, one church did this. And the church now came, saw the video. How can you allow a comedian come to your church and talk about our church doing this? You understand?
Okay.
So me, when I do my music comedy, I balance the equation.
Okay.
I make you see things that you believe.
Yeah.
I'm a member of the choir, so I talk about the choristers a lot. So when I crack the joke, you say it's true. That when you say that somebody took offering, and carries from the, you understand that kind of, just say somebody, maybe a pastor was preaching and they were looking at somebody's, you know that that's blaspheming.
Okay.
So I think those things are the things that should be corrected.
Oh, okay.
And not just be condemned. Just don't just condemn comedians. Correct certain things that you don't want again. Okay. So I think it's just misunderstanding.
Okay, so comedians should stick to clean jokes in church.
In church,
basically. Okay. So let's take a couple of comments. A lot of people, Pinky Pearl, I love you, I love you, I love you. Now, they do this all the time. They don't go tell me, say, I love you. What is happening, people? I mean, ask some guy to, I can crack joke now. Okay, Benny Follower Show says, when you distinguish yourself with a niche, you will surely succeed. Thumbs up, Kenny Blaq.
Thanks, boss. Thanks.
SCN Kemet says, I just finished watching one of your comedy shows, and believe me, it is skyrocketing. How do you deal with comments like that? I'm sure, as a star, walking on the streets and people come to you, do all sorts of, how do you deal with that? Whenever no woman now don't come, Kenny Blaq.
No woman, no crying. Even Bob Marley. I try as much as possible too, because I think I get more love from the people of my age bracket, people older than me a little, the youth especially. But guess what? These days, I actually get love from people who tell me my mom is a big fan, my dad is a big fan.
Okay.
And you see those guys on the street and you're like, hey, Kenny Blaq, can I have a picture? I love you, I love you. What else can you do? Not to love them back, but to make them understand that this love is can be wicked. It's not that kind of love you're talking about. If you want me to love you that way, then you want me to grow.
Okay.
Because I need to focus on making you proud more, making you love me more.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes I get, Kenny Blaq, I want us to, you know, I love you, and I show you my dreams. You're my future partner. I said, let the future come.
So
for now, let's talk to Drake. Let's leave the future out of it.
Okay.
So let the future out of it. Let's talk about now. Eh? Mm-hmm. And it will grow later. So I think I have a better way of talking to those people, and they understand me.
Okay.
And I still love them. I love them from the kidney of my esophagus.
Okay. Okay, you have your answer. Omogai. That's the guy's name. Omogai. He says, you are so amazing, Kenny. God will continue to strengthen you.
Amen.
Melody Nadi loves your voice. Mary Ayeni says, you are the best.
Amen.
When you say you are the best, would you consider yourself amongst the crop of comedians we have out there?
Nobody is the best, though. I think God is the best, but we're all trying.
Okay.
I think if you say I'm the best, the best I can do is to accept it.
Mm-hmm.
But I'd rather much as possible not to let it get into my head. But when you say I'm the best, I want to look at that thing. Okay, why are you saying I'm the best? And when you give me reasons for you saying I'm the best, I go and do more so I can be the bestest.
So anytime they tell you the best, ginger for the
ginger for
me. Okay, and Valentine Ifan Yogene says, Bia, if this guy not sing, I go change hand phone now. Now, Valentine, I had a phone talk now. You understand? He's going to do that. Don't worry. Just calm down. We'll be. Nothing happened. Okay, people said they love your joke. This is from Victoria DBC.
Yes.
It is quite unfortunate that I don't know you too well.
Okay.
I'm wishing the best life can offer you. So now, to people who say they don't know who Kenny Blaq is, how do you react? Like?
July 23rd,
Echo
Hotel, 6 p.m. is my first comedy show ever, Oxymoron of Kenny Blaq. Come see me do 1 hour non-stop performance, and you get to know me more. In fact, you just know me, you will love me. You will want to take me to mama.
Ah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Thank you too. Okay, Samuel was on, says, nice lady. I like that your twin sister.
Nice lady, my brother. Focus on yourself. Now, my twin sister is not available. She's not on any
sales at least. Well, you don't say me bring list.
Bring list first. Let us see. Like, because apart from the list, even the, you need to know if you are fit to present the list. And then the rhyme.
So Omoga is back again. He says, Kenny Blaq, can you tell us your state of origin?
Four bottles. Okay, let's. I'm from Ogun State.
Okay, what part of Ogun State?
Owu, Abeokuta.
Okay.
Not far from the island. So.
Which island?
Owu Island.
Look at this one, man. Okay. Keshi, tell you to says, I love listening to
Keshi,
your
voice. Keshi, okay. Because I was thinking it was your excellence.
No, his name is Keshi. Tell Keshi.
Okay, let's leave Keshi. Let's just use Keshi.
Keshi, okay. Yeah. Let's leave Keshi.
Yeah.
He says he loves you. You're a very funny comedian. You are going places.
Please tell me where I'm going to. That's the problem. Don't go there. You are going places. You're lost. No map, nothing. Tell me where I'll go places. Somebody said you go places then. And believe me when I said amen. I went to places. You know, Paja, Abulegba, Tabotabon. When the pastor said, you are going to
Lagos. Wait, there is no place in Lagos that's Tabotabon.
Who told you there's no place in Lagos that's Tabotabon? There is Tabotabon.
Yeah.
Somewhere on the mainland. Google it. Tabotabon. No, okay. Let's do like a Nigerian who needs money.
Yeah.
More bets. How much?
I don't feel bet.
How much?
You bet money. That's something. Are you serious? Tabotabon
now.
Hey.
Okay. Osino Chuk is asking, why do you always smile on stage?
And he's asking, what tribe are you? We just answered. But just what? Why do you always smile on stage? And he's watching from Dubai.
Hey, Oshay, Auntie Boss Khalifa. I smile on stage. I don't know. I've never noticed that. I've never realized I smile on stage.
Okay.
But the excitement of being on stage alone, as in, it gives me joy. Like, see now, many people, they sit down, they work like this. See now, everybody, they give this attention. So, I don't see myself like a blown. I see myself as someone.
I never blown.
Even when I was on AY Live, I see myself as, I think this might be an opportunity for me too. I see every stage as an opportunity. So, when I see the love that people give me, I just smile like, ah, God, now you. So, when I'm on stage doing those jokes, I remember, but I did this joke sometimes and people did not laugh.
Okay.
But now people are enjoying it. And like, I just smell like, God, that was you.
It's just everything for you boils down to God.
Boils down to God. It's
okay.
God, though.
Okay, so now let's do something. Before right. you even do that, let me ask, first of all, are you going to put out an album like where you just put like that AGO song?
Okay.
Would you do a full album in the future?
You heard it first here.
Yes, Niger exclusive. Listen.
For my show, I'm trying to do all my covers. I'm trying to put them in a CD. A lot of people have asked me, Kenny Blaq, we want to download your covers. Uh-huh. We need your covers. I'm still thinking of it, too.
Uh-huh.
But I might do something, drop an EP. But music, serious music, maybe not now,
okay.
But soon. But for all of you who want to hear me sing all my covers, an EP, don't worry, just come for Oxymoron of Kenny Blaq. I have something for you.
You have Oxymoron of Kenny Blaq. That's a very, 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 very dynamic name. You
yes,
tell
sir.
Us why you even, where that came about.
Okay, first. No problem.
We talk about that. Okay, so Olayinka Adams is watching from Canada.
Okay.
He's asking, when are you coming to Winnipeg in Canada? When are you come to Canada?
Guess what? I'm coming to Canada next month.
Okay.
That is July. I'm coming to Canada next month. I think second week next month. I'm coming with Aporo. I'm coming with Flavor. I'm coming with the Oni of Ife. So you can just check my work. I just posted the artwork. Canada. I think it's Canada at 150. I will be there Canada at 150. So let's have fun together.
Okay. So you heard it here. Olayinka Adams, you should pay us. You should pay us for doing this advert. A lot of people are still talking. You understand? They're asking. Yakubu is asking, how old are you?
Ancient of days, as old as you are, as old as you are, you will never change. Hallelujah. I think I was born. Let me just say I was born in 1992. Let's just end it there. So we'll figure it out.
You was born in 1992. You have
September 30th, 1992. 6 years.
September. September 10. Yeah, yeah.
Ah, September 10. Yeah, September 10. That's the Ember Month. We make the bar.
Great people are born in September.
Yes, yes.
Thank you very much for joining us. It's been a wonderful show. We wish we could stay here all day, man. We've been having a wonderful conversation. You understand? And I'm sure Kenny Blaq feels the same too. We've been having fun. Thank you to everyone who's dropped their comments. Again, we have to apologize for the sound issues we had earlier in the show, but you can see now that everything is working fine. Thank God. So please do not forget that Nights.com is the number one online media in the country. Do not forget that you can advertise your product on this show. You understand? Anything you want to sell, anything you want to sell, this is where your market will sell. Nights.com is the place for you. Please do not forget. How can you do this? Just send a mail to ads@corp.nights.com. That email address should be scrolling on your screen presently. It's ads@corp.nights.com. We have the very, very friendly rates. And let's not forget, this interview is courtesy 1107 Suites and Lounge in Ikeja. Man, see how chilling we are, man. See how we're chilled. Just make sure you come and support the brand. Kenny, before we go, okay. This is Nights.com TV.
All right.
You understand? We are partners with you. Yeah. And we will always support you, man.
Thank you.
But before we go, why don't you just give us, I want to say a freestyle. You understand? A little freestyle.
I think I need to make a phone call. Hello, baby. Your ex called me. He said he's coming over to make me pay for all the things he's done for you. I've been waiting. His number ain't coming anymore. If you got away, I can reach him. I want to let him know that I jeku ya nyoche, baby. I jeku ya nyoche, baby. Any toto ni no tinti no deni. I jeku ya nyoche. I jeku ya nyoche, baby. You be man with the beat, woman. You be moo moo.
Yeah, moo moo. Big one. Guys. Kenny Blaq, before we go, let's tell the people. A lot of us have seen your social media handles. Some of them want to invite you for shows.
Yes, so.
How can they get out?
Okay, my Instagram was hacked, so I cried. I think I cried or shed tears. I can't remember if I cried or shed tears, but it was water. So I'm trying to get my followers back. So please follow me on Instagram at Kenny BlaqMCFR. I reply DMs all the time.
Welcome to Fosville Luxury Hotel. At Fosville Luxury Hotel, we offer excellent service. Our rooms have all the necessary facilities to make your stay comfortable and memorable. You will also have access to internet service, breakfast, 24-hour power supply, full air condition, free international calls, free tire pumping service, and free car battery charge. So what are you waiting for? Quickly visit Fosville Luxury Hotel. We are located as number 1, Adeli Roba Mishile, off Raji Rasaki Road, First Estate, Amuwo, Odofife, Stark Lagos. For more information or reservation, please call us on 080-75-78-7135 or 080-99-90-0601. You can also take advantage of our online ongoing promo at www.fosvhotel.com to make your reservation and payment for your favorite room, which attracts a discount rate. Please note, rooms are reserved based on first come, first serve. Fosville Luxury Hotel, experience the home of comfort. They come.